Hi, I'm Dr. Lindsay from Bluefish Pediatrics, and today I'd like to talk to you about immunizations. Why do we give them? What are they? What to expect? So I'd like to take you back in history, actually to 1796 is when Dr. Jenner discovered that you could use cowpox. That virus contains the name vaccinia, and it make humans immune to human smallpox disease, which was a terrible disease and has now been eradicated thanks to these vaccines. And just incidentally, vaca in Latin means cow. Vaca in Spanish, you might have heard, means cow. And so that is why we have this word vaccine today. Inoculation means putting something in for some purpose medicinally. So that's actually how they got people immune to smallpox. So you might hear immunization, vaccination, inoculation kind of interchangeably. But they're not all shots. For example, the rotavirus vaccine, that is an oral one. So we give a baby a drink to protect them. The live attenuated influenza vaccine, or flu mist brand, that one is a liquid in the nose. So just like the flu virus would get you in the nose, that's where we put the vaccine for that one. Most of these diseases are going to be caused by either a virus or a bacteria. And so what we're trying to do is give a part, like an antigen, and have the body make antibodies. So if you already had these, then you get exposed to the disease, your white blood cells, your immune system will be able to fight that off before it makes you really sick. And so that is why we're giving all these shots to your baby sometimes. A lot of people have concerns about side effects, right? So let's say your baby came for a 2-month checkup, 4-month checkup, got a few shots. You're gonna expect some crying, and that'll get better pretty fast, I promise. But you might see fever, and that's typically a few hours after the shots to maybe the next night. Within 24 hours, that fever is generally gone. Of course, we're giving these in a muscle or under the skin. So when we do that, you might get muscle knot or soreness there. You might see a little bit of redness at the skin site. And you can treat that with a warm compress or massage as well. Rashes, certain diseases like measles, chickenpox, or varicella will cause an illness with a rash. And so in the same way, the viruses in the vaccine can cause a rash, and it's generally 7 to 14 days after. The vaccine information sheet, this is going to be a piece of paper we give you at the visit, and it'll go over specifics about each vaccine that your child's going to get and what to look out for, what to know about it. Safety concerns. So of course people are always wanting us to make sure what we're doing is safe. And I'd like to say that all the doctors at Bluefish are giving our own children all the American Academy of Pediatrics recommended vaccines on schedule. And we wouldn't want to do something for your child that we wouldn't do for our own. Thimerosal was a preservative that contained mercury. So a lot of people had concerns about mercury, of course. And this has actually essentially been removed. And we don't use any vaccines with thimerosal at this particular time. But just as an example of people had safety concerns, it wasn't even really proven to be a problem, but it has been removed to make sure. Whole cell pertussis, this was a vaccine back from the 80s when they used to give the entire bacterial cell to make you immune to pertussis or whooping cough, but turns out that caused a lot of side effects, and so it's safer and cleaner to give the acellular pertussis. That's what we give now. Rotavirus, this oral one we were talking about earlier, that one had kind of an original version that caused a side effect called intussusception at an unacceptable rate. So they went back to the drawing board and redesigned that vaccine, and now we have two licensed, safer versions of rotavirus that we use today. So just some examples of how over time things have improved in terms of safety, or we're always vigilant about that. Immune blunting. So this means this phenomenon where we discovered in 2009 with a Czech Republic study, if you were to give Tylenol or acetaminophen to the baby at the time of the vaccines, it blunted the response. In other words, they didn't make quite as many antibodies. And so for that reason, and more recent data that has kind of supported this, we think it's much safer to not give medication before or with the vaccines, but instead just give the shots and then calm your baby down, love on them, and wait and see if you really need the Tylenol, say, or ibuprofen is also safe to use after 6 months of age, when they need it, when they have that fever, when they're really fussy and crying, then of course we would totally endorse giving it, and we will give you dosing information so you can safely do that. Boosters. So why do we give the same vaccines kind of over and over on this schedule? Well, it's because some of them make an antibody, and for your body, you will be immune. But over time, it could be months, it could be years, the levels go back down. But if we give a booster shot, your body will become really, really immune again. So over time, we've discovered kind of the best schedule we can come up with. For example, DTaP, diphtheria, tetanus, acellular pertussis, 2 months, 4 months, 6 months, and then we give it again at 15 months and 4 years old. And 11 years old, we give this Tdap version, and every 10 years after that, pretty much. So that's just because we know that people don't tend to stay immune forever with that. Another good example is the flu. The flu virus mutates. It loves to mutate and kind of change every year. So the scientists who make vaccines come up with the best guess for this season, which types of strains should we protect against. If we could have a universal flu shot, maybe we could get one and done, and you wouldn't have to get that flu virus shot every year. So we're hoping for that. And just when people ask, why do we give so many shots? Do we really have to? I like to point out human papillomavirus vaccine given to adolescents. It actually used to be 3 doses. And in most cases, if you start at a younger age, it was shown to be sufficient with only 2 doses. So just an example of when we removed a booster, because it turned out we didn't need it and we could be protecting your child with only 2 doses. So less shots is always a win. So just to sum up, vaccine immunization history goes way back to 1796. And there are a lot of different vaccines out there, a lot of diseases we can protect for with these immunizations now. We try to use them in a manner that is as safe as possible. If there are side effects, we will help you through that. If you have any questions or concerns, please don't hesitate to call your doctor or your office. And once again, I'm Dr. Lindsay from Bluefish Pediatrics. Thank you.